Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Vuthy. I'm from Liger Learning Center. Let me tell you something. We are in a new age. First, it was the industrial revolution. Now is the age of information and telecommunication. This age that many call the internet era. The internet of things. And we share so many things through the internet. It's like a sharing world. As you know, on Facebook, we share photos, videos, news, status updates, and more to our friends, our families, and others. And Facebook is very popular all around the world. According to Facebook Newsroom, over 1.7 billion people use Facebook each month. That's a lot of people. Let's see in this room, who does not use Facebook? You know, Facebook was just a startup company, but today it has changed the world. What would you think if Mark Zuckerberg shut down Facebook? What would happen to the world?
Protect.
What would happen to you specifically? You may feel very bored.
I will open it.
Right.
I will start it again.
You may feel like you are disconnected from the world, from your families, from your friends. I don't want this to happen to us, but it is a great example of how IT has changed the world. Google is another startup that has really changed the world. Back to 20 years ago, people used books for researching. But now our life is much easier with Google. Tell you what, there are about 40 searches every second, or 3.5 billion searches a day. And how did I get this data? Google. And I guess most of our test speakers also use Google for their research. Google has changed the world, as well as IT. A lot of things happen through the internet, but you might not know about it. People share cars, apartments, clothes, money, documents, music, videos, and more. And they even share code, and all of it involves the internet. Think about the time before YouTube or Spotify. People had to go to a store to purchase a CD if they want to listen to music or watch a movie. But now, just open YouTube and can stream millions of videos, open Spotify and listen to millions of songs. We almost pay nothing. It's a sharing world. What about money? Who had used Wing before? Wing money?
Yeah, ready.
It's very popular in Cambodia as a way of sending money to other people. Sending money is similar to sharing money. And my mom used to send money with a taxi driver to my sister. But it's not safe. It takes a long time and it costs more. Wing has solved this problem. Wing has changed Cambodia. Another way of people sharing information through internet is called Waze. This app allows drivers to share traffic updates so we can avoid police or traffic jams. Before it was created, people had no way of communicating with others about the problems on the road. But now, look, you can see all the information on the road. Police there, traffic jam there. Okay, go this way faster. You probably know about Airbnb.
No.
Anyone can use this app to share extra rooms in the house to other people and earn some money. People can rent room from the host at a good price. Airbnb is very popular in many countries because guests can interact more with the local culture. Before it was exist, people only choice would be knowing someone living in the place they want to go or pay more for the hotel. Would you want to pay for the hotel or rent a room from Airbnb?
A hotel.
Yeah. Oops. All of these applications and system and many more like them empower the user. They give the people who need the resource with a provider at almost zero cost. It makes the customer like us happier and solves our problems. But without the code, all of this application wouldn't exist. A code is just a bunch of instructions for computers, but it has the power to change the world. Let's say each line of code is a brick for a building. And in this age, you just need a computer and internet access in order to make these bricks. With many bricks built up together, we can create a big building, a big system that could change Cambodia or change the world. Anyone can make these bricks. Anyone can write code, even kids. If I can code, you can code, and a student in Cambodia can code. And coding is really important for developing countries like Cambodia. And we are in a new age, and I believe that every student should know how to code. I think it would be a great idea if Cambodia government school include coding in their curriculum. Currently, we don't have many computers in this country. But what? Most of our high school students have a smartphone, a Samsung, iPhone 5, iPhone 6, or maybe iPhone 7. They can use their phone to learn to code, which means government school don't need to pay much on expensive technologies, computers, and internet. They just need to provide the time and the opportunity for the student to learn. Oops. You don't have to be a genius to code. You don't have to be a genius to code. If you don't know how to code, just learn to code or even try to code. Once you pass the beginning of coding level, you can create a system with less money than it would be a great create a building. Because rebates are not free. Coding is free. Then come up with a crazy idea to develop an application or system that could change Cambodia or even change the world. Coding has the ability to change the world, but it also changed me. Look, 4 years ago, I was an average student like most of the students in Cambodia. I went to government schools. I didn't have any access to computers, internet, and even smartphone. I didn't have any opportunity to learn what I was passionate about, technology. I knew nothing about it. However, since I was given an opportunity to learn in project development school with a focus on technology, I have had a lot of opportunity to explore coding. I have done many projects with coding, and I am a great example of what coding can do for a young Cambodian, what it actually can teach someone. 3 years ago, I was able to compete in a Lego robotic competition in Singapore with 42 other teams, which involve coding. We need to write the code so the robot can move and solve the challenge. And last year, I had a special opportunity to present His Excellency Dr. Ngoc about coding. He has a vision for the future that can be a student gaining exposure to coding. He was interested in an application called Scratch, an app and website that anyone can use, can code using blocks. He realized that the students can make their own projects, simply make a game or animation. Students love playing games. Why would they want to make their own game? Currently, I'm involved in a startup team who is developing a mobile application called Doctor, let's go in English, where drivers can update the information about their taxis so the passengers can get all the updates by sending text message. Our apps have to inform the customers, the passengers, about which taxi is approaching their station, eliminating the time of wait and improve the pleasure of the customer. These are just some examples of what coding I have done with coding so far in these 3 years. Imagine how much our countries will develop if there are many programmers and developers who are making applications and systems that change the world, that change people's problems. And if you want to be a tech change agent, you should know how to code. And if you don't know how to code, just give it a try. There are many websites out there you can learn from. Code.org, Codecademy, Udemy, and more. In conclusion, I want to share 2 quotes from Steve Jobs. First, the people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do. 2, everybody in this country should know how to program computers, because it teaches you how to think. Thank you.